Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am the host, Damon Pettit. And today, we are going to try a cigar. We're going to smoke a cigar that is not even on the market yet. It's coming out. Coming out this year. Not exactly sure the timing. But it's from Ezra Zion. And it is a beautiful looking cigar called the Inception. Very, very nice. It's got a Corojo wrapper and Nicaraguan filler. Very beautiful. Very nice construction. Got just that nice tobacco smell, nothing, doesn't really have any kind of weird, like, barnyard type smell, or, so, really, I really do like their look, their branding is very nice, so, I am very much hoping that I'm going to really enjoy this cigar. I know that they sent out cigars to people to try and stuff like that, and that's what one of these are. I did not buy this. I do not know what the retail on this cigar is going to be. So. I can't put any of that information there because I don't know it. Their website is up. It's kind of like this is all coming soon type thing. They do have a YouTube video about the cigar. It's kind of just an introduction, introducing it. And I will put that link down there as well, somewhere down there. So. Let's take a look at that one more time before I clip it. I'm very much enjoying these this new cutter that I got. My God. Nice draw. I like that already. Let the magic happen, huh? Today is my first day of vacation. I mean, this couldn't have come at a better time, you know? My first day of vacation. I'm going to be going to Colorado tomorrow. Looking forward to that. I have a fan down here because it's hot outside. Not exactly sure the actual temp right now, but it's very hot. I'm going to wait to take a little sip of my coffee. I'm going to have coffee with my cigar. But I want to get some flavor from the cigar only itself. Has a nice bit of smoke coming out. Right in the very middle part of my tongue. Mid palate, maybe you want to call it, right in there. For me, it's like a real buttery nut right now, right at the moment. A little bit, always for for me, a lot of cigars, right at the very beginning, have a little bite to it, small bit of spice, and that usually burns off. We'll see how that it's going to go with this. Very nice aroma. Beautiful aroma for this cigar. So far, so good. Very happy about that. Anytime somebody is going to give me something, I always hope that, you know, I'm not going to say, oh my God. So far. Nice smoke. Right now, just that nice tobacco taste. Just so you know, I just got this in the mail today. Actually came in the mail yesterday, was able to get it today, and it was, you know, wrapped that way, so it was nothing, and it's very nicely got enough moisture in it still. It's humidified well, so it's going to smoke very nicely, I believe. That's already looking beautiful. It's got like it's a box press type here. This cigar, these cigars, at least from my understanding, took over a year to blend to get to where they were happy with it. Very nice cigar so far. The taste is still, for me, just a real, more of the woody, nutty taste right now. I don't know if I have any cocoa hints or any kind of thing like that for me. I think the main thing, at least for me, is that everybody's palate is completely different. You have some people that eat fish all the time. You have people that eat steak all the time. You have vegetarians that don't eat any of that any of the time. And so, everybody's palate is going to be so different. It's gonna be, you know, this person over here eats tons of candy and licorice and stuff like that. They're gonna probably possibly taste something that they're always eating in their cigar. Or at least something that they like that, you know, is always kind of on their taste bud in some way. So, if I say that I taste, like a lot of things, I taste some nuts or... Now, when I say wood, I don't eat wood all the time. Let's understand that. I'm not a psycho. Well, not really. A lot of stuff that I eat, you know, is like some meats, and then I eat a lot of different, some smoked vegetables and different things like that. I eat all kinds of different meats and fish and stuff like that. Try to be a little bit well-rounded in that way. So when I taste something, you might taste something completely different. I think a lot of things, like, I mean, really enjoying this. This very nice, just a very good flavor going on right now. Nothing, like I said, I'm not tasting chocolate for me. I'm tasting real nice, just a real nice tobacco taste. Real good flavor coming out. It's burning very nicely. Uh, for music, I'm listening to Spotify on my iPhone. I don't know if I like it for sure. I've got it on the Enigma station, and I think it's on the station. I don't know what the hell I'm doing with it, really. I just downloaded it. Gonna have a little bit of coffee, see how it pairs. If you've never seen any of my reviews, I really enjoy coffee. Coffee is probably my favorite drink, and then like really nice. I like wine. It doesn't have to be really nice wine. Just I like decent wine. That coffee that I'm having, what's that? Like the CDM coffee. It comes from Louisiana. It's got chicory in it, and it goes really good with the cigar. So, and right now, it's one of those times where, for me, luckily, and I'm very thankful, this is a good moment for me. I'm first day of vacation. I'm getting ready to go on a really nice trip. As long as nothing happens, you never know. and now I'm having this cigar, which so far it's got a great aroma. It's got some nice smoke. Flavor's even changing a little bit. For me, I'm getting that smoked vegetable, like green smoked asparagus, just in there, just a little bit. And it's just what it reminds me of. It's not what it tastes like. It's what that reminds me of. It's a flavor I can kind of compare it to. So any of you out there that hate asparagus, it's not what you're going to taste. You're not going to taste that. I'd be shocked if you were. I don't know anybody who really says that they have a smoked vegetable taste in their cigar. It's just kind of, for some reason, something that hits me. It's got a perfect draw. Very, very impressed with it so far. Very happy that it's smoking nicely. Right now, as of this cigar at this moment, I will definitely be watching for when they come out, and I'll be buying some. It's definitely very nice. Never heard this song before. It's supposed to be Enigma. Now, I don't know if that's a newer one or what. So, I happen to really like Enigma, so. I don't usually, do my reviews with the Enigma type music all the time. I don't know if I've done it at all yet, but there we go. Very fucking nice. That's what I'm going to say so far about this cigar. Excuse the language for those that do not approve of such harsh language, but it is. Look at that burn. It's nice. No, very nice line right there. Beautiful, beautiful white ash. Now, this light has like a weird tint to it. So, it's going to be... It doesn't really... It actually kind of... Like, this is probably a little bit whiter than what you're seeing. That light somehow kind of tints things a little bit yellowish. The last one I did, the review I did, I had a white shirt on and it kind of looked yellow the whole time. And the light blue shirt that I had once looked, had a yellow tint, so. I'll probably never wear that shirt under this light again, I can tell you that. See? Oh, that's smoke, huh? Really intense walnut taste right there. I mean, huge flavor right there for me of like a walnut type flavor. I'm sure the coffee will kind of also affect things, but I'm always drinking, almost always drinking a coffee with my cigar. It's usually wine. It's usually something with a flavor. I drink water a lot, but that's not usually with my cigar. That coffee really complements cigars nicely. I gotta say that. Very, very nice. You can taste the Nicaraguan soil. I'm sorry, a long time ago I saw a review. I really enjoyed these guys I was watching. But then all of a sudden this guy started telling how you could taste all the differences in the soils, and I don't know. I mean, maybe you could, but I guess I shouldn't doubt that. But actually tasting the soil from a tobacco, maybe, I don't know. I honestly, I've been smoking cigars since, 1920, something like this. No, not really. Since when? I'm trying to remember exactly when it's. It had to have been like 1992, 93. So a little bit now, and I don't know. If any of you have feedback on that, let me know. If you think that. Would be able to actually taste that. I don't know. It doesn't really matter. It was just something that threw me a long time ago. I was like, what? Now, trust me, to me, if you can taste that kind of thing, that is fucking great, fantastic. That you can actually get those different things.
See that? You know what that is?
It's a man without a watch today. I don't care what time it is. I really don't. Whoa. Very flavorful. I even got some sort of a taste there of something that I've had before, and I don't know. I'll have to see if I can place that taste. You can tell the construction of this cigar is beautiful. It's wonderful. From what I know, they've also gotten some of the really top-notch cigar rollers, I believe from Cuba, to roll these cigars. Once again, bravo to the cigar roller. To the person that rolled this cigar, thank you. Done a very nice job. And once again, I do wish it had like like a little scan, one of those little scan things. You could scan it with your phone, and the face of the cigar roller would come up or something like that. That'd be cool, huh? Or just the information of the cigar roller, like where that guy's from. But, you know, how much money they make. Just kidding about that book. But that I still think that would be fun, to be able to kind of put a face to the roller of your cigar. Just my idea. Wow. Thank you, Ezra Zion, for letting me do this. Really appreciate it. It's very, so far it's very good. Very delicious. It's something I will, so far, I mean, unless it goes into the crapper, which by now, I'll be shocked. I will obviously be smoking it all the way down here, so we'll see. But, so far, I'd buy these babies any day, and I'd seek them out. Very woodsy. For me, a little bit woodsy taste. Smoked. Very flavorful though. There's absolutely a lot of flavor coming from this for me. And the ash is holding like there's no tomorrow. I'm not even gonna flick this baby up. We're gonna just see how it goes. It is about 11 o'clock at night, actually, but it's a rather mild night. It's not humid. I think we had some of the hottest weather that I have felt since I've been here. I came here in 2000, Arizona, United States, in case any of you don't know where I am. My address is, I don't want you I mean, I wouldn't mind meeting you, but right at my door, I don't know, that'd be a little weird. Really, this, it's kind of funny, because I really like the size of the cigar. The ring gauge is nice. I'm guessing this is either, I don't know if I want to guess, but 52 to 54 ring gauge, maybe. I have a little ring gauge thingamajig, but I forgot to take a look at that. That might be, it might be off, but that's probably in the vicinity. It's anywhere between a 50 and a 99 ring gauge. I think we know it's not 99. That'd be like a pipe. Like a pipe you get in a sewer. Huge. I really want to knock this ash off. Not a big fan of keeping that around. Keep it a little bit longer here. See how long I can do this, you know? It's Thursday. I'm trying to think if there's anything. Oh, that first little show, the Comedians in Cars. No, Comedians Getting Coffee in Cars or something like that. It's a Jerry Seinfeld project, really. And it's just on the internet. You can see it on YouTube, you can see it on their website, its first little, I guess you can almost call it webisode or episode or whatever you want to call it. It's like 14 minutes long almost. And it's just him and Larry David kind of going back and forth talking. And for people like me, it's a good thing. It's a good little thing of entertainment. They have some, you know, kind of funny moments, a little bit, not like rolling on the ground type funny. See, this baby is going strong. We're going to see how easy this comes off. Can you see it? So, I actually tap it a couple times. You can tell it is not tunneling. It's looking very nice, very sturdy. It's smoking like a champion right now. So now I got to clean that up, but it's all right. I'm outside, it doesn't really matter. Until I've got this $1,000 chair here. I actually really want to get some much better chairs. But with every chair I buy, I would think, oh, I could buy this many cigars. Fuck the chair. I'm only kind of liking this music, though, for me. I'm trying to pull this different flavor. There's a different flavor going through right now. It's very nice. It obviously changed a little bit since I'm drinking some coffee with it now. But it's very nice. Like I said, it's got this really nice flavor going on, and it's more of a medium. It's not a strong cigar. So you know, if you like a punch you in the face with a bat strength of a cigar, you know, I'd still try this. Yeah, at least try it, you know? Because my tastes go back and forth between I really want a really nice strong cigar to I kind of want a lighter cigar every now and then. Sorry, I thought maybe my hair was kind of messed up. Didn't want to look funny. The aroma, that's something that, for me, kind of tells me a little bit about that cigar. You can smell this different, nice, clean tobacco, really. It's like a real good, deep, deep flavor, and that's very nice. I wish I had a little bit more info, like, you know, as far as, like, this has been specially aged or anything. You know, I don't know all the different processes that these ones have gone through. All I know is Nicaraguan tobacco, Corojo wrapper. Maybe that's all I need to know, you know. But it's, like I said, I really want to know the cigar roller. I would like to shake his hand, or her hand, I don't know. Or maybe it's rolled by two people at once, I don't know. Maybe three. If I could, I would tip them. I've said that before in a couple other interviews. A couple other my little shows/reviews. I think some people don't really like my thing as a review because it's so freaking long. But, you know, so... we're going on 30 minutes right now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and pause and smoke this baby, relax, probably watch an episode of Family Guy here, and hang out, enjoy the shit out of this. And I'm sorry, I've got potty mouth all day today, so don't worry about it. And I'll be back, and we'll see how it's continuing on. It doesn't look like I'm going to have to do anything other than sit here and enjoy. So, we'll see what happens. I'll be right back. Again, it's just that little swoosh, and then you'll see me again. You won't even know I was gone. Let's go out like this. Ready? That's better. Hello. Look at that. Son of a bitch. It's really good. Very, very delicious. I am now down the band, taking the band off. Beautiful band, I will have to add. Really, really, I like the art of the band. If I was a superhero, I'd want my stuff to look about like that. It's pretty nice. Same smooth, consistent flavor. I don't have any harshness. Smoking beautifully. I knocked the ash off a little bit ago. So I only did it twice. And just fantastic. Yeah, it's a must try. Bookmark these babies, EzraZion.com, I believe. I'll have links on my videos on the definitely on the YouTube page, and honestly, like I said, I was hoping it was going to be good because it was something that was given to me. I did not pay for it. And I like to be as honest as I can. I like to be honest, period. I don't, you know, bullshit anybody about a cigar if I don't like it. I believe I've had maybe one cigar out of all my reviews that I really didn't like. A few with really bad draws, that kind of thing. This is very nice. They call it a boutique cigar. Boutique. And I don't know what the price point is going to be on these, but it's going to be worth it. I can tell you that. And I will definitely be purchasing them when they come out. I would definitely recommend doing the same if you do. And then you would smoke it. Let me know what you think. Come back to this video, either on my website, right here, somewhere, wherever you are, YouTube, Vimeo, my website, Facebook, wherever it is, and let me know what you think. And keep an eye out for them, because I have a feeling they will be talked about. I'll be surprised if not. I was going to sit there and watch Family Guy, but I ended up doing. It's going out there. I have like an extended huge patio out there. There's a waterfall thing back there. I'm just listening to that, looking at the stars. I have some trees right here, a couple palm trees as well. Just kind of looking at all that together. Smoking a very, 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 very nice cigar. And it's the Inception by Ezra Zion. And let me get that out one more time and put that away.
Take a look. Can you see it? Look at that. Okay.
Give them a try. I have a feeling you'll feel like I did. You'll want more. So, it's a big thumbs up. Big A plus score. Very much delicious cigar. I didn't get like any harsh. There's no harshness, no extra acidity coming out at all to me. It's not even bitter. Smooth flavor all the way through so far. We'll be smoking probably another 10, 15, maybe 20 minutes depending. And but this is where I'm going to end. Sorry, I had an itch. This is where I'm going, on my ankle. And this is where I'm going to end my little review. And I'm going to I'm going to get this posted so that it's up tomorrow, and which will be Friday. I'm leaving tomorrow. I don't know, do one or two maybe reviews in this next 10 days. I'll be up in the mountains. I'll check in, all those little things. Hope everybody just has a fantastic, fantastic night, day, whatever, wherever you are right now. I hope you're having a good time. I hope life is going well for you, and I hope things are just smooth and no bullshit problems. And if you're having any problems, just take it a step at a time. Just keep going. You'll get to that other side. Trust me, I was there on another side just a little bit ago. Things always smooth out no matter what. And this life is too short to not live as much of it as you can. So definitely do that if you can. Just keep thinking good little positive thoughts, all that kind of stuff. And go smoke a good cigar. Give these a try. Thank you very much for watching. I'm just extremely thankful that anybody watches it at all. But thank you. Feel free to comment. Feel free to say hey, whatever you want. And I look forward to seeing you again soon, smoking with you again. And take care of yourself. Bye-bye.